Hey, people. Yeah, I sure wish I was playing Kingdom Hearts 2 Final Mix, but no. We're playing Birth by Sleep here. I have not given up on, the Mass Effect thing yet. I was playing it earlier. There's more things I gotta do to wrap up the game. A couple of side quests actually opened up, so I was just like, man, I might as well. Like, I'm trying to, like, sweep through every quadrant, getting all the little collectible things. I thought I already had a save. Yeah, go ahead. I thought I already had save data for Birth by Sleep. Or no, that's the PS3 version of it. I think that's what it was, yeah. Because I'm playing the all-in-one package here. I know I'm going to get docked for the intro, so I'll probably have to talk through it. Like, pretty much all of Kingdom Hearts intro musics are copyrighted the fuck out of when it gets put on YouTube, so I'm going to be talking through it. I mean, pretty much everyone knows this song anyway. It's simple and clean, I think. Getting me. Tetsuya Nomura. Yeah, he had good ideas. He just went fucking insane with the story, in my opinion. Like, Birth by Sleep, when the game came out for the PSP, it still made sense in the context of, like, you know, the universe. It's pretty much as soon as they got into, like, Dream Drop Distance, where it had, like, fucking, like, time travel and stuff. It's just like, man, come on. When you walk away, don't hear me say, please, oh baby, simple and clean as the way that you're making me. Damn, James Earl Jones fucking passed away? I know Star Wars fans are fucking moping and whining. I mean, he had a cool voice, don't get me wrong, but he was also the voice of Mufasa. That's unfortunate. He's definitely pretty goated. I'm definitely gonna be upset when Mark Hamill passes away. I mean, he's fairly up there in age now too. Kitty, what are you doing? What are you doing, Kitty? No shit. I was trying to actually make a. I thought about having a latte today. Like, I went to the store. I got some Amish cheese. I got some Munster, and I got some Colby. Which is delicious. I also got some, like, what do you call it? I got some, burgers as well. So. But, I just lost my train of thought there. I'm sure it's not important. Yeah, Kitty's playing with a paper bag right now. Oh yeah, I was trying to make a coffee today before the actual stream, but I forgot the last time I made a latte. I kept the milk in the container. I didn't put like that container back in the fridge, so it went like really sour and gross. So I had to wash that fucking thing out. I was like, okay, well, the system is probably disgusting now, too, since it had, like, you know, milk running through it, you know? So, I was trying to clean it out using, like, the clean function on my, espresso machine. And I guess it, like, overheated or something, because it just kind of, like, stopped working. And I was like, okay, let's try turning it off and unplugging it for now. So maybe I'll get a latte at some point, I don't know. Yeah, it's gonna say no file, but I have played this before. I played it on the PS3 version. So only because I've heard Xehanort in this game, like the secret boss or whatever in Final Mix, I've heard he's a bitch. So I think I'm actually gonna be playing on standard mode. There's no way in hell I could do ain't no way in hell I could do it on critical mode. And I highly doubt I could even do proud mode. So I'm gonna go standard. Want the vibration on. You just finished eating a supper. Yeah, I had a couple ears of corn today. After I came home from the shop. And I had a couple slices of Colby cheese. It was either two or three slices. I mean, it don't matter. And like I said, I felt like having a latte, but my machine's being kind of weird right now, so maybe in another like 20 minutes I can get me a coffee or something. Just to tide me over until, I mean, technically it could be dinner time now, but I'm gonna stream a bit first. But yeah, Mass Effect I'm not quite done with. I just have to do more side quest stuff. I should be able to do it tomorrow. Like, I essentially have space homework to do. And of course, I gotta get the rest of the stuff from Tomb Raider all, as well, so. But I was like, I'm close enough to the end of those two games that I might as well start on this one. Is this a different intro, or is this the same shit that just played? I'm pretty sure it's the same thing, isn't it? Yeah, it is. Yeah, I don't want to get tagged twice for the same intro song, so. Because, like I said, YouTube and Twitch, they do not like that being played uninterrupted. That's why I was talking through it. It's a good song, though. But yeah, this is probably a solid game on the PSP. I never played the PSP version of this game, so.
This world is just too small.
Yeah, pretty much everyone knows who that is, especially if you've played Kingdom Hearts 3, so.
There, you see, an empty world, like a prison. I imagine you will be right at home.
Who's there?
Okay, you actually have the PSP version of this game. All the KH song OPs go hard. KH3 intro song, I didn't really care for all that much. It was too, like, dubsteppy. I think that's just kind of a me problem, though, like, because I've never been into, like, dubstep shit. But yeah, KH3 song, it didn't really hit it with me, unlike, you know, the artist's other hits. It might have been just a sign of the times. Like, I don't keep up with her actual music. I just know that they've used her songs for all the KH games, and they've also reused a lot of ones. Like, I'm pretty sure they I think they've reused Simple and Clean like fucking four times, it seems like.
Why are you in my heart?
I always love this fucking this song though. For the Station of Calling or whatever it is. I believe this song is called Dive Into the Heart.
Yeah.
Really, really good song in my opinion.
That was my light. But my heart is fractured. And now the little I have left is slipping away.
Yeah, join your heart with Sora, damn it. Uh-oh, spoils. Spoils. There's a bit of corn stuck in my teeth. That's why I was kind of messing with it earlier. But yeah, I figured today I could at least kind of like do the intro and pick the first path or whatever you want to call it. Because you play as three different people in this game. I always love looking at these like stained glass kind of mosaic things. I always thought they looked fucking cool. As a project, I should probably make one of those like in Photoshop or something. I could probably pull something like that off. For I don't know, like a Disney character maybe. I thought that looks so sick to me. I still wish we had gotten to hear Leonard Nimoy for Xehanort in KH3.
Ah.
Yep, he's got that Keyblade!
A Keyblade!
A lot of Keyblades in this game. I'm not too familiar with all the story intricacies of this game. I know it takes place 10 years before the events of the first Kingdom Hearts. I do know that. What the fuck is this room? Oh, I know where I am. I know where I am right now.
A meteor shower.
Technically speaking, the world that you start out in, you've seen it multiple times. It's actually pretty clever, pretty clever twist it gives you. Yeah, this is the Land of Departure. Your tutorial area, so to speak. This game where we learned the Keyblade wasn't as special as we thought it was. Yeah, that is true. Well, I mean, even if you've only played, you know, the first two Kingdom Hearts games, like, you already know that, like, you already know the Keyblade isn't exactly a, what do you call it? It's not a, I'm not sure how I feel about X being attacked, to be honest. I hope I can switch that. I really feel like X should be jump, but I might have to get used to that.
I've got time to spare.
I don't think I can change that button, so I'm just gonna have to get used to that. Yeah, get health orbs, blah blah blah. There's a couple worlds I actually like quite a lot, like the one with Stitch in it, like you go on like a spaceship. I always thought that was kind of cool. Can I not lock on yet? I guess I can't.
Yeah, win.
There we go, now I can lock on. Can already use Strike Raid, huh? That's cool. Now, there's a specific ability that you pretty much have to spam throughout the whole game, which is another reason why I'm not playing on a proud mode. Because I know Xehanort is, like, stupid hard.
Gotcha.
If you don't spam certain things. Sliding dash command, okay.
Wait, what am I messing around here for? I'm gonna miss the meteor shower.
You know, now I think about it, I don't even think I ever bothered to get the ultimate weapon in the game. I don't think I ever bothered to do that. But yeah, like, back to the Keyblade, you kind of have a feeling, like, when you play the first two, that, like, the Keyblade, it's not exactly, like, you know, it's not exactly the Sword of the Stone. Like, it's not Excalibur, it's only meant for one dude to wield. Like, it's kind of...
Why does it seem so...
Kind of finicky.
Familiar?
I mean, technically speaking, in the very first game, we know Sora had one, we know King Mickey had one, and we know Riku had one, so that was at least three, wielders.
Whoa!
Fucking kernels in my mouth. Hello, baby.
Give me a break, Aqua.
Ven,
probably the biggest
You know, you should have at least brought a blanket.
But did I dream that place up? It really felt like I'd been there before, looking up at the stars.
Except you've always lived here with us.
Yeah. I know.
Aqua is definitely, like, the bae of this game, by the way. And yes, I'm aware she's technically underage, but I don't really care.
Hey, Aqua.
But I believe,
You ever wonder what stars are? Where light comes from?
Oh, shut up.
Well, they say...
That every star up there is another world.
Huh? Oh.
Terra.
Yep. Hard to believe there are so many worlds out there besides our own. The light is their hearts. And it's shining down on us like a million lanterns.
What? I don't get it.
In other words, they're just like you, Ven.
What does that mean?
You'll find out someday, I'm sure.
I want to know now.
You're too young to know now.
Quit treating me like a kid.
Hey. What are you laughing at?
I can't help it. You two would make the weirdest brothers.
Huh?
Huh?
You prefer X being attack and circle being jump? Aqua voice actor was in the Arrow TV show? Huh. Definitely would not have known that.
Yeah. Terra, you and I have our Mark of Mastery exams tomorrow. I made us good luck charms.
Whoa.
Here.
I get one too?
Of course. One for each of us.
Yeah.
Somewhere out there, there's this tree with star-shaped fruit. And the fruit represents an unbreakable connection.
It's on Destiny Islands. You should go there.
Luck charm shaped like it. Nothing can ever drive you apart. You will always find your way back to each other. Technically, I think you're supposed to make them with seashells. But I did the best with what I had.
Boy, sometimes you are such a girl.
Hey.
She ain't a girl. She's a woman, sir.
So this isn't a real good luck charm?
Especially with the shit she has to go through eventually.
But I did work a little magic on it.
Really? What?
An unbreakable connection.
We got a Wayfinder, one of three good luck charms Aqua made for herself and her friends the day before the Market Master exam. Okay, I think I forgot about that mechanic. You can do Dimension Link? Okay. Huh. Alright.
Well, tomorrow's the exam. Anybody want to spar?
I can take it.
So yeah, the thing with Ven is, if I remember right, he is the fastest one out of the three. Oh, I'm actually Terra right now? Okay. HP gauge represents your health, round of HP, and you're dead. Use square to defend yourself, press it while moving to slide. Or square while holding to block, okay. Okay, yeah, that's right, I forgot, Yeah, X, square is defend, okay. I guess it's been a while since I played a Kingdom Hearts game, so... Because the last one I played was Rechain of Memories, nothing was quite like that, so... You know, because it was a card system. You fucking prick. I don't know why his HP's not going down, but whatever. Sun Edge, bitch! Sliding Dash, bitch! Queen. What sushi played as? Terra slow and powerful, Ven is balanced and aqua magic in a glass cannon. Yeah, something like that. And I'm going to start with Terra as my branch because he is the slowest motherfucker.
Well,
so I'm starting with him first.
Fighting one-on-one, but you need to know how to handle
it. Doesn't really matter what you it doesn't really matter what order you go though. Yeah, you just shot lock command to hit a lot of enemies at once. That is technically the only actual good way to play this game, is to use the shot lock. If I remember right, that's the,
Freeze!
What button was it? R1. And apparently I've got a Bubble Buster. Yeah, it requires focus, which is more or less your drive gauge. From two, pretty much. And I guess your D-Link is your, like your magic.
Okay, let's
so.
Wrap this up.
Yeah, if I recall, they borrow a couple of these, they borrow a couple of these characters for, a couple of these mechanics for Kingdom Hearts 3, if I recall right.
Gotcha!
Which is kind of cool.
Take that! Gotcha!
Finish that bitch off.
It comes with experience.
Want to spar again? No. To my understanding, there's no reason to do that. Yeah, I don't know if I'll,
Trust me. You guys are
I don't know if I'll be getting, like, all, like, the trophies or whatever in this game.
I hope it's that easy.
But I'll try to. Like I said, the reason I don't have it on proud mode is just for that secret boss fight. I've heard it's a pain in the ass.
You just need to look inside yourself.
Especially with Terra. I can find new strength by playing on the command board? I guess I don't remember that mechanic. Access the command board and at save points or the world map. Commands in your command deck become your game pieces, and you also obtain new command. Okay. I clearly do not remember that mechanic. Okay.
Oh.
That's definitely a save point.
You don't want to lose track of stuff that's happened.
Okay. Yeah, the weird thing about Ven is he uses his Keyblade like really weird. I don't know how the fuck that's comfortable for him, but you know, whatever. Oh, there are two secret bosses, huh? You would start with Terra, and then Ven, and then Aqua, because it seems to always be the best order for you story-wise. Yes, create a save system, please. And that's on there already, right? Like, that did save it? Yeah, okay. Cool.
Hey, we're gonna head back.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah, if I remember right, individually, I think each character's, like, playtime is around, 6 hours, if you watch all the scenes? I don't quite remember.
Together.
This is kind of a game to maybe stretch out, though, stream-wise, because you are going through basically the exact same worlds, just from different perspectives.
That would be the last night we ever spent beneath the same stars.
Shit's gonna go down, unfortunately. Ooh. Hey, look, it's Mickey. Ooh. Doing something. Surfing? Oh, that's right. He's training still. Yeah, he isn't a master yet. That's right.
Mickey, I cannot shake the feeling something terrible is about to transpire.
I kind of like how they have Yen Sid as sort of a recurring character in the series. I think that's kind of neat. Even if you just see him in cutscenes, like I think you talk to him Dream Drop Distance and at the very very start of KH3. In this game, you choose one character at a time and complete his or her story from the start to finish. Each character visits different places and meets different people. And only by finishing all three stories can you uncover this tale's deeper truths. Yeah. Okay, yeah, they actually even tell you, what's up. Yeah, Aqua is basically the spellcaster, Ventus is kind of like your quick fighter, and Terra's like your slow, heavy hitter. So, we're gonna start with Terra just because I hate how slow he is, so... For the secret boss, I'm probably gonna have to level him up the most.
Today you will be examined for the mark of mastery. Not one, but two of the Keyblades chosen stand here as candidates. But this is neither a competition nor a battle for
strength. Definitely four, but you must do the Mirage Arena for the others.
But a test of heart.
Yes, it is Disney spelled backwards. I know I've heard that before, I just forgot.
But I am sure our guest, Master Xehanort, did not travel all this way to see our youngest prospects in years fall short of the mark. I trust you are ready.
I'm ready for a latte. That's what I'm ready for.
Then let the examination begin.
But yeah, if I remember right, this guy's name is Eriquis or something. Okay.
Don't worry about me. You two focus on the exam.
But Ven,
you're in danger
here. Go wait in your room.
No way. I've been looking forward to this. seeing you two become masters.
But yeah, if I remember right, Terra and Aqua are both 17, and I think Ven is 15.
He's been out there training just as hard as us.
Yeah.
So they're basically adults. I'm assuming I'm Terra during this, right? Yeah, okay. God, you're fucking slow, dude. Jesus fucking Christ. I don't know how these things have money, but okay, I can roll with that, I guess. Damn it. I was gonna try to do shot luck on him. Yeah, I think every character's shot lock looks a little different from each other. In terms of the animation. Alright, maximum HP increase, learn critical impact, that's cool. Do I recognize his voice? If you don't, it's Master Aquas is voiced by Mark Hamill. Oh. You'd think I'd know that since I just praised about him. Yeah, so what happens sometimes is your command gauge can give you like different sort of styles for shit. I don't really know all the ins and outs of it, but I know for sure that they took that concept and put it in 3, which is kind
of
neat.
Even in the most trying of circumstances, it was an excellent test, one I chose to let unfold. Which brings us to your next trial. Now, Terra and Aqua, the two of you will face each other in combat. Remember, there are no winners, only truths. For when equal powers clash, their nature is revealed. Begin!
Sorry if you're hearing a bunch of noise, there's something on the mic. Whoa, what was that? That can't be good.
We have deliberated and reached a decision. Terra, Aqua, you both performed commendably. However, only Aqua has shown the mark of mastery. Terra, you failed to keep the darkness within you sufficiently in check. But there is always next time. That is all. Aqua, as our newest Keyblade Master, you are entitled to certain knowledge. Please wait here for further instruction.
Hey.
Terra, I'm sorry.
The darkness, where did it come from?
Gee, I wonder.
What do you make of Ventus?
He ain't gonna cut it. Somebody's gotta break that loser in.
Not here, you won't. I have to keep up appearances.
I know that. He just needs a little incentive to leave home.
Sorry. But I need some time alone. There's darkness within me. So what does that matter? I know I'm strong enough.
Always forget to switch back if you want to continue unlocking the others.
You are indeed strong. The darkness has nothing to fear.
Master Xehanort.
And yet, how frustrating that Ericus refutes its power. Why, you could train with him forever, and still You'd never be a master in his eyes.
But why? Help me understand, Master Xehanort. What is it that I failed to learn?
You're fine as you are. Darkness cannot be destroyed. It can only be channeled.
Yes. Thank you, Master.
I see he's into the foreboding purples, huh? Foreboding portals, not purples.
What happened?
I don't know. Why isn't Ven here?
Very well, then. I will send my pupils to investigate. Yes, I understand.
Oh, another cool world that you go to is the one with Snow White, which is kind of neat.
That was my dear old friend Yen Sid. As you know, he is master no more, but he still keeps a close eye on the tides of light and darkness. His counsel serves as signposts on the road we wielders of the Keyblade must walk. All the more reason then for concern. For he tells me the princesses of heart are in danger. Not only from the forces of darkness, as you may assume, but also from a new threat. One that feeds on negativity. Fledgling emotions that have taken monster form. Yen Sid calls them the Unversed. As wielders of the Keyblade, you are tasked with striking down any who would upset the balance of light and darkness. The Unversed are no exception. I tried to pass this news on to Master Xehanort, but my repeated attempts to reach him have failed. I doubt there is any connection, and yet this all troubles me.
Master Xehanort is gone?
So here we are. I need you two to get this situation under control. Eliminate the Unversed. And find Master Xehanort. I have unlocked the lanes between. You may use these forbidden pathways to travel between this world and countless others. The darkness looms closer than usual within these spaces, but your armor will protect you. Lastly, remember that order must be kept. You cannot tell anyone there are other worlds. Now go. And fulfill your duty.
Yes, Master.
Terra, consider this an opportunity. A second chance for you to change my mind.
What?
You must know. I care for you.
You always like the Stitch, Hercules, and Radiant Garden Worlds.
If I could have my way, I would name you Master in a second.
One of the secret bosses is in the Mirajina arena. Is pretty cool because its move pool, like, is based on your characters.
Terra.
Huh.
You mustn't be afraid of
Yeah, I'll definitely be focusing more on the Mirage Arena. I remember being okay, but not nearly as cool as the, like, Olympus Coliseum thing.
You must never
That reminds me. Yeah, you go to that in this game too, and you meet Zack, don't you?
Master.
I'm pretty sure you do.
Swear.
I always thought that was a cool little, tidbit. And it sort of makes sense, you know, for, like, Final Fantasy VII lore.
It's okay.
I don't think you do much in the Hercules world, though. I could be wrong. Don't. Yeah, anyone who's seen, two final mechs definitely knows what that armor's all about. Fucking pain in the ass fight, that is. Although, debatably one of the best secret bosses in any game. Like, it's a damn good fight. I don't know. Maybe when I play 3, maybe I should get the Remind DLC. I don't know, people. Like, I've seen it on sale here and there before. But like when the game first came out, I did not give a single fuck about giving Square any more money. But I think I've seen it on sale half off before, so it'd be like $15, I think. I don't know, I'd have to ask people's opinions, I guess. Forge a D-Link with Ventus, nice. Well, D-Linked, you can use the other character's commands. Oh, that's kind of interesting. D-Link will drain as long as you remain linked. When the gauge runs out, your link will be broken. D-Linking also fully restores your HP. Refilling the gauge by collecting these D-Link prizes. Okay. Defeating enemies while D-Linking may cause them to drop special emblems? You can grab those emblems to power up the D-Link? I don't remember that mechanic at all. Huh. Okay. Journey begins. Unlock the command board for the land of departure. Okay. Yeah, for once they did, they did something kind of right in the Kingdom Hearts series. They made it so you don't have to do that fucking gummy ship nonsense, you know? You just go to the worlds and you're off. I believe that's the what you call it? The arena. Enchanted Dominion, I believe this is the Sleeping Beauty world. Which is also cool too, because I fucking love Sleeping Beauty. Go and visit this bitch. Tara's voice actor was in the Supernatural TV show? I definitely want to know about that. I think I've seen like one or two episodes. I thought, this is boring. Why the fuck does anyone watch it? Definitely get the Remind DLC. It's good the secret boss is a pain in the ass, though. Hardly ever used the D-Links. Huh. But yeah, this one, the Snow White world, and the Stitch world are probably my favorites, other than, I guess, you know, the graveyard at the very end. So yeah, these things called Unversed.
The ones the Master mentioned. These are the Unversed.
I just call them Heartless. Like, I feel like they're supposed to be the same exact thing. It's just, we didn't understand. 10 years ago, I think they were just under a different classification. Like, they're pretty much Heartless at the end of the day, in my opinion. I see a treasure chest there. Critical impact! Critical impact, bitch! Most of your time in the Mirage Arena when you play to get your level up if you need to grind. I'll try to do what like 100% is considered in each you know, mode or whatever. I don't know if I have the patience to actually get up to level 100 unless they give you a certain amount of experience or something. I don't know. Like, I think when I initially played this game, I think I only got up to, like, the bare minimum to beat each story, so we'll just see how.